Good evening. I'm talking from the Museum of Parabiago, a town near Milan in Italy. Professor Nunzia Borelli asked me to talk about the relationship between food and landscape. Landscape is at the center of the work of the Italian Ecomuseum. In fact, Ecomuseum are both cultural institution and development stakeholders. They help communities to use the living heritage in a sustainable way. And you know that sustainability concerns culture, social, spiritual, and economic dimensions. For this reason, ecomuseums develop multidisciplinary projects. They know that everything is connected and that nature is a complex and interconnected system, that the planet is a work of communion and that human beings are called to live in harmony with the planet. Sustainable landscape of food is both a relevant issue and also the name of a project that the network of Lombardy Ecomuseum developed in the northern of Italy. In this region, the Lombardy, 34 ecomuseums were recognized by the regional law and worked together in a network. Just start with landscape. Landscape is a system of interacting ecosystems. Interactions also affect neighboring landscapes and the entire planet. The landscape is constantly evolving. It is not a static system, but a historical one, in which the present is in relation to the past and the future is in the relation to the present. Eugenio Turri used the metaphor of the landscape as a theater. He wrote that if life is representation, then the landscape is like a theater where the scene is the territory and the entire planet is the stage for the humanity's play. Turri described man as an actor and a spectator, who becomes a growth factor, a mediator between ecological knowledge and a sense of memory, and a promoter of projection and safeguarding. But Turri and the Ecomuseums emphasize the importance of the education to see the landscape, acting only as actors, forgetting to become spectators, has caused here and elsewhere deep wounds and great diseases in the landscape. Landscape diseases concern not only urbanization, land consumption, landfill, quarries never restored from an environmental point of view. A great disease is also the fragmentation of ecosystem, as in this area at the north of Milan near Parabiago. The action of nature and man over the course of millennia has left traces in the landscape that are still evident today. To read the landscape and understand its changes, it is necessary to strip it of the various layers that have settled over time. A suggestion to understand the landscape. Let's try to recognize the signs that anonymous or well-known heroes of the past left in the landscape. These heroes helped to shape the landscape and make it the way it is today. Heroes are not just people. For example, the Po River plains is daughter of the Alps. From the Alps came the floods and built it, filling the ancient gulf. From the Alps came the waters that gave it life, fertility and wealth. The heroes are the glaciers and that formed the amphitheaters of the Pleistocene, then the rivers and the streams that transformed them and formed the Milanese plain. Then the living organisms that made the plain livable for man. This is the landscape of the Eighth Milanese Plain near my home. You can see Alps, a Pleistocene terrace formed by glaciers. Other hills formed by glaciers where you find the pre-Alpine lakes like Como Lake, Varese Lake, Maggiore Lake. You can see also the Olona River Canyon and the streams that descending from the Pleistocene terrace flow in the last lowlands hoods. I give you another example. This is the Oglio River Plain near Mantova in Lombardy. In this sort of photo you can see both the actual bed of the river and the old bed of the river. The hero here is the river that formed the plain. But then came the men, first Celtic men and then Roman people. In particular, in the Roman age, the woods were cut down and the land surveyors, called agrimensores, divided the agricultural lands into regular grid which are still visible today. The aim of this extraordinary work was both to drain the waters that sampled the area and to divide the lands that were assigned to the settlers who had to cultivate them. In my opinion, farmers are the heroes of today. Farmers produce food, but for two millennia they have contributed to maintaining the agricultural landscape with its biodiversity. Over the last 70 years, farmers have transformed themselves into food producers. Only recently, the EU agriculture policy stopped financing food production with the subsidies from European citizens and has started financing the cultivation and care of sustainable land and produce both healthy food and ecosystem services. But the Farmland Bird Index showed that the agribusiness isn't sustainable. In Lombard, for example, half of the agroecosystem birds biodiversity was lost in the last 23 years. Many Italian ecomuseums are empowering farmers to leave agribusiness and start agroecology. Agroecology produces both good food and ecosystem services that, for example, are landscape, biodiversity, oxygen production, climate regulation, and so on. The slide shows the food and the services in the Parabiago ecomuseums. We produce milk and wheat, but also support biodiversity and take care of paths and grassland. You'll find a lot of examples of projects by Italian ecomuseums, but I'll talk you about two examples from the Lombardy region. A place that I know better and also because I worked on these two projects. The first concerned the design of a product and related ecosystem in services, the bread of Parabiago. The second regards in particular the design of the communication, participation and networking. This is the project of the ecosystem Lombardy Network. Let's start from a product, the bread of Parabiago. This is the diagram of the circular economy of the bread of Parabiago from 2015 to 2020. It is inside a more comprehensive circular economy strategy of the Ecomuseum and the town of Parabiago. The loaves were produced in local bakeries with the whole meal flour, made with the mother yeast, Parabiago water and salt. The soft wheat flour is of an ancient variety called San Pastore and is stone ground in the last remaining water mill in the area. 117 hectares of agricultural fields are cultivated with the conservative agriculture. This agriculture impacts in a minimum manner on the ground. It reduces CO2 emissions, preserves biodiversity and humus. The fields are fertilized by the compost produced in local farm from vegetable waste coming from the public and private gardens of Parabiago. Local bakers sell bread which is also served in school canteens. We worked hard on the participation and communication issues, but we had a problem. This is what happened in 2021. A newspaper wrote that the bread of Parabiago was grown on polluted lands. It was a fake news, and the mayor of Parabiago tried to explain this, but the local bakery stopped to produce and sell the bread. At least the flour of Parabiago is still produced by farmers that sell it in Milan to make pizza. This problem shows how communication and participation are very important issues. The Lombardy Ecomuseum Network in 2016 developed a project called Sustainable Landscape of Food. This is the workflow of the process with the help of the Polytechnic of Milan University and a degree thesis, we explored the role of design in the Ecomuseum's project. The Sustainable Landscape of Food project involved various Lombardy Ecomuseums around the themes of sustainability and local gastronomy. In this case, design offers strategies, guidelines, and tools to encourage the participation of ecomuseums and people in the enhancement of the landscape and in the development of the territory. Some design solutions to improve and expand the project, making it more visible and accessible to communities and the public, have been developed and a website has been published. The website is in Italian, but I auto-translation it for you. Sorry for the bad translation. The interpretative vision of the project is a tasty journey. Sustainable Landscape of Food is a journey of discovery of the food and landscape of the Ecomuseum of Lombardy. The website invites to discover the most significant elements of the landscape, live the best experience and taste the typical food. And then we find another interpretative vision. The landscape is a bit like a special book. Each page contains some sentences already written previously, so that the last page, the only one visible in reality, contains sentences that were written many pages before. We like to think of the landscape as a theater of actors and spectators, scenes and stage, heroes and common people. Sustainable Landscape of Food puts Lombardy's Ecomuseum online through the common thread of sustainable and food. Each Ecomuseum offers its own itinerary made up of nature, history and community. Here is another interpretative vision. Each Ecomuseum's itinerary makes up a single large path through which to cultivate the landscape. It doesn't matter if you don't own land, you can cultivate the landscape of Lombardy's Ecomuseum simply by testing the typical products, visiting the cultural heritage and participating in events. Then you find how the communication project works. For all the Ecomuseum you find short description with maps of OpenStreetMap, which describe elements of the heritage, some local food and wine products, and finally an itinerary. The various information can be explored in greater detail via links to Wikipedia and Wikiwire pages and the Ecomuseum website. It is clear here that the project uses open source project. We can go, for example, to visit the Valmarenco Ecomuseum. It is on Alps. Here you find some heritage elements, not only architecture and natural beauty, but also knowledge, tradition, and workmanship. Here the food section that talk about pizzoccheri, a special pasta with vegetables. And finally, the itinerary to discover the area. So, thank you for your attention. And if you want to cooperate with the Ecomuseum, please just ask me or join the European Ecomuseum Network. Good evening to everybody.